Hello everyone, Robert Rambles here, and welcome back to the Season of Discovery and our Dwarf Priest. Today I'm hoping it'll be a really good one. We are going to be healing the Deadmines. We have our group together, we're heading in. One of our fellows had some PvP issues running from Red Ridge through Elwyn Forest. They got ganked by some horde. It happens. We're going to try not to accidentally attack any horde members. Like, I don't want to get flagged up. I would just love to do this run. We do have the quest for the head of Van Cleef. With this group, we're not going to be doing any of the stuff on the outside of the instance. So we'll have to get that done another time. But the important thing here is that we get the staff of Westwall. Not really sure if that is like Biss, pre-raid Biss or not, but it should be good for us no matter what. Let's see, it looks like we're going to try to get a summon off here. We have a warlock in the group. He's level 19, which means he can't do it. You gotta finish the run, yeah. So because he's level 19, I guess he can't be summoned? I don't really understand why. Everybody here is level 19 besides us. So, yeah. Let's have a look here. He's on his way, you know, he's in Westfall now. Not too far. I just wonder if he's still flagged up. I mean, that Torin being flagged up here, he was, you know, basically just asking for it. I guess I should put that ability, I should probably switch that out, right? Let's go ahead and we'll put, we're in combat. Let's put this on our legs. I wonder if we need prayer mending that much, you know? Like, in reality. But we'll go ahead and we'll mess around with it. As soon as we ever get out of combat, here we go. And as far as who is tanking, I have to assume it's the druid. We don't have anybody else in the group that can tank, so we'll wait till everybody gets in before we buff anybody up here. Probably take this guy out. We need that too. You know, the one thing I did not think about was buying water. So we actually really did need that. That being said, I mean, ooh, it's level 5. That's gonna be rough. That's gonna be a tough one. Yeah, I really should have stocked up. I'm just not used to healing. Also, like, furthermore, I'm just not used to needing to drink. I haven't drank on this character. We drank maybe once. And yeah. Okay, well, I mean, it's better than no water at all. I'm gonna have to be popping this, like, every single fight. Like, no matter how much mana we use or don't use, I'm gonna have to pop this every single fight. It's going to become part of our rotation. every time we're out of combat, we're going to have to hit it, even if we only get a little bit back. Because otherwise, it's going to get really rough. The other integral ability that I don't have out of my healing bar, because I'm such a noob, is, Power Word Shield. Like, the bread and butter of our very existence. I really don't want to have to use Flash Shield very much. So I'm going to move it. Yeah, I hope this will be okay. When somebody asks your tank if they're the tank, and they say, sure. That's always good, right? Let's buff everybody up. And then immediately drink. It's gonna be a tough run, I think. I really needed to have that level water. Like level 15 water. I needed to have it, and I don't have it. I'm gonna try not to, like, continuously bubble my tank.
Van Cleef pay big for your head.
I need to change my party frames. Like, right now. Okay. That's better. Gonna be a painful run. Yeah, I should have probably left and gotten water. For some reason I thought the mage water was gonna help, but yeah, it's not really helping us to keep our mana, get our mana back, etc. I'm gonna sit out this pull and hope that I can get back into things here. I really hate warlocks mana tapping themselves down. You get a renew. Like, I don't have anything else for you besides a renew if you're just gonna mana tap yourself down every pull. procking Spirit Tap sometimes would be really helpful. Like, we procked Spirit Tap there. So that was good. We are going to sit for a second and get at least a little bit more than half of our mana back here. And we have ads. I'd love to be able to drink now. In fact, I must be able to drink now. I'm still in combat with something. I have no idea what. Super annoying. Apparently we're leaving these guys, which is not good. Like, we're probably gonna pull them on accident. that mana potion, as little as it is, might come in clutch. You know, probably during the last boss fight.
Check out that noise!
Our tank has stopped being a tank. I'm not really sure how I feel about that. I don't have a lot of good feelings about it. I really wish they would go back into bear form. That would make me feel better. Now they don't have the mana to shift into bear form. I do not like where this is going. I guess he decided that doing damage was going to be more valuable than tanking. I'm really not sure. I didn't see anything said in party chat. Sometimes humans do baffling things. That's the risk of doing things with other humans, is that every once in a while they're going to do something that's super effing confusing to you. There we go, there's a bear. I like that for this situation. I hope they go bear for the fight, but it doesn't look like they're going to. There we go.
cover them.
You really don't want to let them both stay up, because then you're just taking so much damage while you're stunned that you don't have to take. I'll always just kill the adds first before DPSing the boss. And there's the green weapon. See, it's not always a blue weapon, guys. It's hardly ever a blue weapon. It's usually a worthless green. Well, that was super fucking unfortunate, because now I don't know if I'm going to have the mana to heal through this pull. We might be okay. We might be okay. I'm after this, though. Like, I am going to have to stay back here for a minute and hope for the best. I hope he pulls him back. Okay, good, good. I hope he stops and lets me drink to full before he pulls the boss. That'd be really amazing. It doesn't look like he's going to. Like, how dumb can you be? This is fucking really bad. Like, I'm really, really upset. Like, I know it probably doesn't sound like it, but I can't really express how mad I am that he just pulled this. Like, there's no reason for that kind of shit. Like, you did the whole dungeon. The whole dungeon, you know? You did the whole thing. And, you know, like, you didn't pay attention. You didn't pay attention to anything the entire time, and that was fine. And, you know, it went on and on and on. You never paid attention to anything. And now here we are. Like, I just don't get it. I don't know what's wrong with people. Please go back and play retail.
None may challenge the Brotherhood.
Like, if you're ever gonna look at your healer's mana, at least look at it before boss fights. Like, if you're never gonna look at any other time ever in your life, if you're that stupid, please at least look before you pull a boss. Alright, now we can actually give it a real attempt.
None may challenge the Brotherhood.
Our cause is righteous.
I'm gonna roll on this. I'm assuming the warlock is gonna roll on it as well. And probably the mage, because, you know, it's cloth, so. In my mind, spirit is more of a healer stat, but yeah, you know, what do I know? Let's make sure that we're actually looting him. Unsent letter begins a quest. We did win the shirt, so. I doubt we're gonna win the wand also, but we'll give it a shot. We won the effing wand. Oh man. The funny thing is, like, yeah, it's better. Right. Okay, it was worth the heartache there at the end. I don't think we need to run out. I think we can go ahead and hearth back to Sentinel Hill. So yeah, that ended up being a very, very lucrative run. We're gonna get the staff from the quest, we got the shirt, and we got the wand. So that's actually really, really amazing. This is gonna all help us out a lot. As far as putting this back up, let's go ahead and do a Void Plague here before I forget. I mean, let's be real, the shirt looks really good too. So, that's always a bonus.
What can I do for you? Go with honor, friend. Light bless you.
Alright, now we gotta head back to Stormwind. I wanna learn staves, and I wanna get this sucker equipped right away.
Good day to you. See you later.
Thank you.
lightly with you. For the Alliance.
Might as well learn both of them now. And yeah, there we go, guys. I mean, what a great run. Despite the fact that we had a lot of tanking weirdness, despite the fact that the tank decided to tank in caster form for most of the run, we came out of it really good. I've never gotten this many blues from Deadmines before. I'll have to take back all the bad things that I've ever said about Deadmines. And then, you know, I'm assuming like all we really want now is that we probably want to upgrade into the Robes of Aragal. Although I don't know, because like there's a lot of spirit on this. You know, granted, that's not a lot of int, but spirit is mana regeneration. And as a healer, mana regeneration is kind of what we want. Like between the staff and the shirt, we're doing pretty good. So yeah, just a couple more pieces to account for, you know, get into a couple other blues. We'll be able to make the blue boots eventually when we get our iridescent pearls. So that's another blue. And then we just have a few more slots to solve for. Thank you guys very much for joining me on this one. I really do appreciate all of the continued support. I am going to take a break here for now. And next time, I think we're going back into Red Ridge to actually do some questing. So I hope to see you then. Until then, take care of yourselves out in the real world and take care of each other. And we'll see you back in Azeroth again very soon. Bye for now.